Carmen Petrovici. I'm a data expert and research associate at LIS Cross National Data Center in Luxembourg. In this presentation, I will introduce you to the main concepts of labor market used in our two databases, Luxembourg Income Study and Luxembourg Wealth Study. Our labor force status aims to capture the current main activity and distinguishes mainly between employed, unemployed, and not in the labor force. Among those not in the labor force, we distinguish between retired, in education, disabled, and homemakers. Additionally, we have two extra dummies, EMP and EMP ILO. EMP is created directly from LFS. Therefore, all those with code 100 in LFS will be flagged as employed in EMP, and they will also be considered ILO employed. All unemployed and not in the labor force from LFS will be recoded as mainly not employed in EMP, while in EMP ILO, those who are marginally employed, for example, a retiree that works 5 hours a week or a student with a student job, will be coded as ILO employed. Therefore, EMP ILO has a larger universe of employed than EMP. When we have the ideal content of current main activity in the original database, you'll see a note for LFS and EMP like this one from Austria. However, we don't always have the ideal content in the original data. Therefore, if the question, "Did you work at least 1 hour last week?" was the first filter in the questionnaire, and only those who were not ILO employed were asked why they did not work, you'll see a note like this one from Australia. We might also have only the activity status in the income reference period, and then you'll see a note like this one from Canada. The labor market variables have different reference times. Job characteristics refer to the employment status at the time of the interview, while annual weeks worked and the flag for working full-time the entire year refer to income reference period and are asked to all those eligible for labor market questionnaire. It is important to be aware of this when, for example, you use current labor force status in conjunction with income. Someone who is retired at the moment of the interview would have been employed in the reference period and can have weeks variable field and yearly labor income. Status and sector are two other interconnected variables. For status, we use the ILO International Classification for Status in Employment, which distinguishes mainly between dependent employed and self-employed. Among the employees, non-regular ones could be, for example, the trainees or those marginally working. Among the self-employed, we distinguish between employers, on-account workers, unpaid contributing family workers, and members of producers' cooperatives, a code which is rarely filled, mostly in developing countries. All self-employed are in the private sector, even some occasionally do contractual work for the state, while the employees could work either in the private or in the public sector. LIS currently provides three occupation variables. Occupation 1_C, it's a country-specific variable at the most detailed level received from the data provider and can be an international classification or a national one. Occupation B1 distinguishes between 10 major groups based on ILO International Standard Classification of Occupation, ISCO either 2008 or 88, even 68 for very old datasets. You can see which classification was used in the label of occupation 1_C variable. The most aggregate variable, occupation A1, has three categories: managers and professionals, other skilled workers, and elementary occupations. LIS currently provides up to 5 industry variables. Industry 1_C, it's a country-specific variable at the most detailed level received from the data provider and can be either international classification or national one. Industry D1 has 21 major groups according to UN International Standard Industrial Classification of All Economic Activities, ISIC-4, and is provided for recent data, mostly starting around the year 2008. Industry C1 has 17 major groups according to ISIC-3, and it's provided for data prior to using ISIC-4. usually either Industry C1 or Industry D1 is provided, depending on the classification used in the original data. In rare cases, if we receive detailed national classification at least 4 digits level, like in Mexico, we will harmonize into the both variables. Then we have Industry B1, for which we collapse the 21 ISIC-4 major groups from Industry D1 or the 17 ISIC-3 major groups from Industry C1 into 9 categories. At the most aggregate level, we have Industry A1 with 3 major categories: agriculture, industry, and services. Additionally, we have information on the hourly net and gross wage in the main job, although rarely from a direct question, most of the time being constructed from the monthly wage and hours worked. There is also variable counting the total year's work for those of you interested in work histories. We have a dummy for currently being on maternity, paternity, or parental leave, and a dummy for any indication of informal labor market activity. The informal dummy can flag, for example, the employees working without a working contract, or working without being insured, or self-employed with an undeclared business. We do not aim to flag here those who produce goods and services only for their own consumption. You can find the exact content of the informal variable in the notes by country. These are the labor market variables available in our databases, which can be used in your research in conjunction with income and wealth. Thank you for listening. If you have any questions regarding our sociodemographical variables, please send an email to petrovic@lisdatacenter.org. Enjoy working with our data!